just give me a little bit insight, you know, on MTN. I don't think I will spend a lot of time on MTN. I think here in the room, let me see, because I'm not a technology-driven person. So I have to see if I push the right button. Yeah. So I think, you know, we are in a 21 country. We have 116 million end of 2000. And, on the 30th of June 2009, our subscriber number will be released soon. I can't tell you what is the number right now, by end of December, but it is growing. We are into 21 countries, you know, operating as operator, and we have also our MTN business, affiliate and sister, headed by Angela. Big round of applause to Angela, doing ISP, and the team is here to support, you know. And we are having also, we have invested in the last 3-4 years, you know, in acquiring in some country ISP, because we did feel, you know, that the convergence was already here it was present. And I remember that 10 years ago, you know, we had a lot of paying a lot of consultants, you know, to guide us on what is convergence between IT and an operator. And today, you know, Apple and Google and Facebook are really the example of the convergence. And we as operator, we are facing a lot of challenge, yeah, especially in our emerging market. You know, we tended, you know, to be in the past a little bit complacent, you know, because it was all to put infrastructure in the ground and offering voice. But today, you know, the consumer is really the king. So we did in the past some innovation, you know, and I won't bore you with this. But here, you know, you will see really that there is a lot of convergence in all, if you want, the field. You know, I mean, you all hear last week, you know, announcement, Microsoft with Nokia, you know, so there is industry convergence, there is terminal and device convergence, there is digital convergence, IP and service, you know. And I think this phenomena has really speed up a lot in the last few years, especially, you know, spearheaded with the food company in California, who don't understand what is Africa, you know. So I mean, Apple have a lot of problem, you know, to understand, you know, where is Africa, and tend to think that we are all living in tree and eating bananas all day. Yeah, so I mean, we will have really to show them that, you know, we are very in advance, and we are also going very strong, if you want, in the convergence. I mean, actually, this is represent really the threat and the reality of today. You know, a few years ago, everyone had a camera, we have a watch, we have a computer at home, you have, everything, we had a credit card, you know, you do banking and so on. Today, everyone is converging into the mobile application. With your mobile money, your mobile wallet, you can pay application, you can buy very soon with the NFC, with a machine to machine, you know, with you can do more than everything. You can book very soon. You will see also in South Africa, in our emerging market, and I don't like, if you want, the word emerging market, because we have emerged by far faster than certain developed countries who claim to be developed. Yeah? So I think for me, you know, who is now looking at the time on watch? Most of the time we have the reflex, we look at our phone to look at the time. The biggest camera manufacturer in the world is not Canon, is not Fuji today, is Nokia. Yeah? They are the biggest camera manufacturer. Yeah? So I mean, you know, so 85% of the music today, yeah, is downloaded via internet. So I mean, the whole landscape is changing, you know. You are not going into musica, you know. So I mean, everyone has to reinvent the business model, because everything converges via the mobile. And of course, in the business segment, you know, via cloud computing, software as a service, you know, which is a really ICT driven. So for us, as a mobile operator, our business model is changing radically, because there is a shift, and there will be a shift from voice, you know, into data. and in the so-called developed country, you know, the data revenue represent already 30 to 40% of the revenue are coming from data. Of course, you know, we say, well, in Africa we love to speak, you know, of course we like to speak, but if I am 18 years old in South Africa or in Algeria or, you know, in Ghana or in Guinea-Bissau, yeah, or in Libya, you know, I have the same aspirations that are used in the US, in Europe, or in Japan. I want to download music, I want to do enkipenki.com, dating, you know, I want to do dating, I want to do, you know, so I want to do everything with my mobile, yeah? And there is no difference. So for us, the gap between developed market and our market, emerging market, is closing very, very, very fast. You know, and for us as an operator, it's a challenge, is how you really compose. You know, and here, because I've only 20 minutes, but I could speak for hours, you know, so you have to stop me, you know, I need to have a timekeeper, you know. So actually, if you want, what has changed for us, really, the landscape, is that the consumer is completely under control, you know. So the time is over, you know, where an operator could put, if you want, capacity, put network somewhere, you know, and that the consumer, you know, was buying it because there was no other choice. But as we now, as there is convergence, as there is a data, everyone is aware, you know, that I can download music, I can receive the new, I can, you know, do everything soon with my mobile. So if you want, this is, if you want, the shift from the operator dominating to the control of the consumer who can really choose you if you don't have a rich value proposition. Yeah? And it is a challenge for us because as you can see, you know, everyone is trying to eat a little bit a part of our breakfast every morning, you know, because the operator used to have a big pie, you know, and why we don't go there. So you have the manufacturer of device who is going into the application store like Ovi, like Apple, you know, then you have also, of course, our good friend from Google, and I hope there is some specialist here from Google, you know, which are my good friend, you know, and all those players, they are not putting any infrastructure on the ground. So they are using our infrastructure, if you want, to bite a little bit in our revenue. So, I mean, our challenge as an operator, you know, is how we play also in this fair. So, I mean, we need also to make sure that we protect, you know, our investments that we have put in the ground, and we move from a big pipe, you know, just putting infrastructure into a smart pipe. So for us, really, the big, if you want, strategic intent that we have already embarked in the last 2 years is to play into ICT, in cloud computing, in data center, making sure that we have connectivity, the investments that we have put also in a cable, in a wax cable, in easy cable, to bring capacity on our market. Because data is nice, but definitively it is also a big consumer in capacity. So I think for us, you know, as you can see here, you know, not too much people or company are providing the connectivity. We are providing connectivity, and others, you know, are trying, if you want, to get advantage at no cost, you know, of our infrastructure. And of course, if you let it happen, you know, then you become really a big pipe and you are not capable to give to your consumer the rich value proposition. So one of our, yeah, is what I was telling you now, you know, how we move from a big pipe to the smart pipe is really by really linking and having strategic partnership with content provider, you know, going into cloud computing, hosting environment, you know, we have a lot of assets as an operator. We have a charging system, you know, we own the customer, we know who the customer are. So that means a lot of things, you know, that the Facebook of this world, Google of this world would love to have, you know. So, but of course, you know, for us, you know, when we are going into partnership, we have to take care, you know, that we give only the finger and, you know, someone wants to take the whole arm. So then for us, we have to be very careful on how we do it. I think, you know, cloud computing, I don't need to tell you because you are all very familiar with cloud computing. But we MTN, together with my colleague from MTN Business, you know, is one of our biggest strategic intents, you know, how we go into cloud computing, what kind of service we are doing. And of course, you know, there is a security concern. You know, we have already put data center, you know, in a regional data center. We are already having the connectivity between our 21 countries. So we have already invested a lot, you know, in the infrastructure to provide, if you want, a data server. But of course, we are not capable, if you want, because we are not specialists in ICT. You know, we will have to partner, you know, with the right partner. And here you can see when we go to cloud computing, HP, IBM, Microsoft, and many partners are already there. And we actually are, if you want, discussing with partner, you know, how, you know, we bring, if you want, all those pieces together, you know. So for us, if you want, we are playing at the moment between the hosting infrastructure, but definitively our ambition, you know, is to offer to the small and medium enterprise a hosting solution and a one-stop center, you know, where, you know, we can really, if you want, use software as a service, you know, and give our small and medium enterprise a solution. Yeah. So I think, you know, I don't need to tell you the benefit of the cloud-based. I'm sorry, I rushed it a bit because, you know, I've been given 20 minutes, you know, and I thought it was 200 minutes. But, you know, so the zero is at the wrong place, it should be. So I think, you know, also in rural area, we can really make a difference, you know, by really penetrating our rural area very strong. And we are doing a lot in the capacity in a rural area. So I think, you know, this is an innovation opportunity. We have put a lot of investment in the rural area. We are really pushing very strongly smartphone and feature phone and GPS enabled low cost on phone. We have a huge connectivity, you know, I mean, all our country are connected. We have the cable, you know, coming into our country and works will be sometime in the second half of this year. You know, we have very good relationship with the device manufacturer, you know, and of course with a SIM card manufacturer who provide already a lot of application, you know, already embedded in the SIM card, you know. So I think the challenge is really that in some, I mean, you know, the low disposable income, but, you know, as I say, the price of the device is going down, the tariffs are going down, you know, we are going to the so-called freemium. You know, freemium is you have to give something free and to charge something to the consumer. So I think, you know, that over the time, you can see that the penetration, yeah, you know, in our market, in average, you know, besides South Africa, which is different, but, you know, we have achieved 50%, 60% penetration in our market. When we started in Nigeria 10 years ago, yeah, there was only 400,000 fixed line in Nigeria when we started, you know, and today in Nigeria, you know, there is 85 million subscribers. Okay, we wish, I mean, we have 55% market share, or 50 plus, sorry, yeah, and 50% market share, and in a market like Nigeria, I mean, we have really make sure that we really help to really reduce the gap. Yeah. So I think, you know, the problem, the regulatory is really a challenge. You know, how we innovate, how do we get the spectrum, LTE spectrum, you know, is a big challenge if you want to grow ICT, you know. So, and I think, you know, what is important for us is really to understand the market segmentation. We really, and we are doing a lot of effort to understand our customer, what is relevant for our customer, you know. And I think when we go into cloud computing and a software as a service, you know, a lot of time, you know, my colleague come and say, well, Christian, what is a cloud now? You know, I am in the cloud. I don't know really what do you do with a cloud. And then we are environment friendly. People speak about ecosystem. And now you come with a cloud. But what do you want to do? What do you want to offer? What does the client, the customer need? And for this, you know, we will link with partner, you know, who are really a cloud specialist, you know, who can really help us, you know, to bring to the customer the right value proposition. Yeah, and of course, the bank penetration and credit card is for us also sometimes a challenge. But we are, with our wallet and the mobile money, you know, we are really trying to overcome, if you want, the challenge. So I think, you know, in 20 minutes, I think I have really passed the time. You know, I'm really sorry, guys. You know, you know, but if you let me start, you know, I will never finish. But sometimes it must be an end in everything, also the good things. Okay, thank you very much for, I hope, you know, I've addressed a little bit, if you want, the landscape and the challenge for an operator.